We haven't seen this prototype truck in a long time, and this is our chance to see the 2022 Toyota Tundra towing a trailer in the wild. And huge thanks go out to Jake Ebert, who actually was out there in the Colorado mountains. He was able to capture some of these images and this video clip of the Toyota prototype towing a trailer in the mountains, which is very exciting. We haven't had an update about the Tundra in a few months, actually, so I wanted to take this opportunity and actually update you guys on everything we know so far. This particular prototype you see in this video clip and images still has the old cab, and the rest of the truck is camouflaged. The rear bed is camouflaged, the front is camouflaged. Even the rear suspension has some camo around it. So what does it all mean? Will it share the cab with the current Tundra moving forward in the next generation of the Toyota Tundra, which is supposed to come at the end of next year, 2021? I don't think so. I think this is an early prototype that's still there, and they're doing some powertrain testing. And of course, everybody's question has to do with, you know, what's going to be the new power for the Tundra? Is it going to keep the V8? Is the 5.7 liter iForce going to stay? Well, all the signs point against the V8 staying, actually. All the rumors we've heard, all the information unofficially that we know about the Toyota Tundra point towards a twin turbo V6 gas engine. So, and also there are some rumors about a hybrid, a V6 turbocharged engine with a gas engine with an electric motor hybrid system. So we know that Toyota has made a few trademarks recently. They trademarked the name iForce Max to the maximum. And of course, they have some other technology, engine technology that they trademarked or have a patent on, patent application. And there's also talk about kind of an automated hitch that's actually be able to deploy a towing hitch by push of a button. So they have certain applications for those technologies, but we don't know a lot about exactly what's going to make it to production yet. But the rumors have to do with this 3.5 liter twin turbo. And that sounds very familiar once again, because Ford in the F-150 trucks, they use a very similar displacement, 3.5 liters V6 twin turbo in their EcoBoost powered Ford trucks. Toyota has the same, well, not the same engine, but the same displacement engine in currently in their Lexus sedans. For example, the Lexus LS has a version of this engine with 416 horsepower and 442 pound-feet of torque. And my bet is, and this is kind of me guessing a little bit, that that same technology that's been proven in the Lexus sedans, which is a very smooth engine, it's a rear wheel drive platform, it can be mated to a 10-speed automatic transmission. My bet that this powertrain will actually make it its way into the next generation Tundra. Again, will it have the same power ratings? Probably not, but it needs to be competitive against the Ford engine. So for 2021, as we all know now, Ford F-150 is redesigned. They updated the engines, their towing ratings, their payload ratings, even the hybrid, the F-150 hybrid. So if Toyota wants to compete, this V6 twin turbo needs to make about 400 horsepower, which should be pretty easy, and 500 pound-feet of torque, because that's the new rating on the F-150 engine. Of course, the F-150 hybrid also uses a 3.5-liter V6 twin turbo with a electric motor sandwiched between the engine and the transmission. This is Ford's modular system. And if the rumors are true that Toyota is working on something similar as a hybrid system, of course, Toyota has a lot of actually knowledge and capability in this area. They've been building hybrids for decades. It's probably their time to actually apply that technology to the truck because it needs to tow a lot more. And this prototype you see here and similar prototypes we've seen in the past are actually switching from 5-lug hubs to 6-lug hubs, which means they're actually upgrading their payload capabilities, making bigger axles, bigger hubs, maybe even bigger brakes, et cetera, bigger components to actually handle more payloads. The current F1 or the 2021 F-150 is going to be rated to up to 3,300 pounds of payload, which is crazy for a half-ton truck. That, of course, is a V8-powered F-150. And then the twin-turbo F-150 is now rated at up to 14,000 pounds of towing. But here, of course, we see, you know, the clips of this Tundra towing, but the trailer that's behind it, I don't think it's super heavy. Just me eyeballing the trailer, I can see the two-axle, tandem-axle trailer, and it's pretty short, it's not very long, not very tall. So my bet it would be this is about 7,000 pounds they're towing, maybe 8,000 depending on the axles on the trailer. So, I mean, that's reasonable. Most people would tow that much, especially in the mountains as they're doing right here in Colorado. So, but will the Toyota be rated higher? I think it should be to be competitive. Right now, the Tundra is rated at around 9,900 pounds maximum towing, maybe 10,000 pounds in certain configurations. I think they need to go way higher, maybe to 12,000, maybe 13,000 pounds, because they need to compete not just against Ford, but Ram and Chevrolet, GMC, and even Nissan with their Titan. So, but that takes me to the suspension. The suspension is still camouflaged. So what are they doing? So a couple of options here. I'm pretty sure it's still a solid rear axle. I think Toyota would probably keep that. But instead of doing leaf springs, as I've been doing, it may be a coil spring configuration. I doubt they're going to go with air suspension, but I think coils, maybe with a 5-link in the back, similar to the Ram, maybe they're looking into that for handling and just overall quality of ride, also off-road capability, and actually, you know, towing capability and payload. I think they might be working on that. Otherwise, why would they actually camouflage their rear suspension? So yes, so we don't know a lot still. We do know that Toyota is planning to launch the next generation truck probably about a year from now. We still have to wait some time, but it's really refreshing to see another prototype actually in the wild, because Toyota is being very secretive about this. You don't see a lot of them testing. We usually see them here in Colorado, but we haven't seen them here, gosh, for maybe a year even. So thank you, Jake, for sending these images and this clip. And go back to tfltruck.com for all the latest news, views, and real-world truck reviews. And of course, hopefully soon, much more information about the Tundra.